Namaste. Today we will see how easy it is to take care of kalonche plant and its propagation. Kalonche are very beautiful ornamental plants with different colors of flowers which last for very long time. So how to take care of kalonche? Kalonche needs a good amount of direct sunlight, but not the harsh light. If you are keeping it indoors, then it needs a bright indirect sunlight. So you can keep it on a southwest window. The plant should be potted in a well-draining soil. It doesn't like to sit in a water. So what does a well-draining soil means? After you water the plant, the water should disappear within 1 to 2 minutes and drain out from the holes. Whenever you water the plant, water it thoroughly. So when to water the plant? You can just insert your finger in the soil, and if top 2 to 3 inches are dry, then only water the plant. Else you can use the pH moisture meter if you have it. The commonest mistake which kills kalonche is excessive watering. One should remember that it is a succulent variety of plant. It won't die if you forget to water. Next comes the fertilization. Fertilize the plant only when it is showing new growth or it is blooming. You can fertilize with regular vermicompost. Add bone meal to encourage new growth. Now we will see how to propagate the plant. Use a sharp cutter or a blade or scissor that is disinfected with the alcohol. Select the stem, which is thick and about 4 to 5 inches long. Remove the lower leaves, if any, on the cutting. So it has 3 branches. I will be snipping it into 3 more cuttings, which can be planted separately. Once these cuttings are ready, we will keep the cuttings on a piece of paper to form the callus at the end. It is like a scab which forms after we get cut. It will take around 3 to 5 days. So this is callus formed and it is ready for transplant. You can dip these cuttings in rooting hormone, but I am using here is cinnamon powder. It acts as a rooting hormone as well as it prevents fungal and bacterial infection of the cutting. Just dip the tip of the cutting in the water and then roll it in the cinnamon powder and let it sit for some time. I'll also be using the leaves which are removed from the stem, and same method is followed. Then comes the planters in which to be planted. You need a planter with a good drainage holes at the bottom. Next comes the potting soil. Here we will be using cocopeat, perlite, homemade compost and vermicompost. I am using homemade compost here, but you can skip it if you don't have it. Then you have to fill the containers and pack the potting mix tightly. Make the hole in the center of the potting mix and insert your cutting into it. Press the soil around the cutting to fix it in the potting mix. Water it lightly just to moisten the soil. Do not wet it too much. You can place other cuttings in the jar of water. Just insert the tip inside the level of water. So these are ready. Now keep them where it receives indirect sunlight. Keep the soil barely moist. It may take up to 2 to 3 weeks for the roots to form. I'll show the course how the roots are formed in these cuttings. they have started forming roots and they can be transplanted into the soil at this stage. These were the cuttings from water. Now I will show the cuttings from the soil. They have also started rooting, not as big as from the water. This is the leaf I have planted. This is also showing some root formation. And this is the cutting showing root formation. I'll keep them in the same potting mix for some more time and then they can be transplanted to the bigger container once they show new growth. The potting mix for the plant will be like this. I hope you enjoyed the video. I have shared best of my knowledge and experience in this video. Do share your views in the comment box. Thank you.